Welcome back to OKTV. Got lots of showbiz treats in store for you guys tonight. In just a moment, we'll be finding out how celebs manage to maintain long-distance relationships.
And later, it's set to be the biggest comedy of the year. We'll be meeting the cast of the hilarious new movie, Bridesmaids.
Now, when you look at celebrity couples, you'd be forgiven for thinking they have it pretty easy. And like most people, they don't need to argue about the cleaning or who spends too much money from the joint bank account, do they? Oh, no. They've got it all, haven't they?
But what about their busy lifestyles? The fact they're often jetting off around the world without each other must be pretty tough. Oh. But loads of celebrity couples do seem to make their long-distance love work. But how?
Yes, we'll be asking relationship expert Simone Bien in just a moment. But first, here's Katie.
We love it when our favourite celebs get together, cuddling on the red carpet, holidaying in the sunshine. It all looks so perfect. But it's not always easy for A-list couples to deal with the pressures of fame and distance, as their schedules mean they often spend a lot of time apart. Nicole Scherzinger admits to feeling the strain. She says she finds being apart from Lewis Hamilton difficult as she juggles filming the American X Factor with her music career. More than a month is a little too long. I wouldn't wish long distance on anyone. I know that as much as I support him, he sees other drivers who have their girls with them the whole time. Leonardo DiCaprio's recent split from Bar Raffaele was said to be partly down to their careers pulling them in different directions. Keira Knightley and Rupert Friend are also said to have struggled to cope with being apart, as did Hayden Panettiere with her ex, a boxer who had to divide his time between Germany and the States. But don't despair, celebrity lovebirds, because Mrs. Will Smith begs to differ. The mum of two reckons spending time apart has been key to their 14-year marriage. People think that Will and I don't spend a lot of time together. Too much time, actually. If you ask me, it's always nice to have a little time apart. Sometimes you need that. And it seems Russell Brand and Katy Perry would agree. They apparently like to spend time apart in order to keep the fireworks in their relationship. Beware though, Desperate Housewife Eva Longoria once said it was distance that made her marriage to Tony Parker work, but that relationship ended in divorce. So, whether you're a beautiful A-list couple or Mr. and Mrs. Nobody, it seems one thing is universal. It takes work to keep your love alive.
Well, let's find out more about how to make a long-distance relationship work. Relationship expert Simone Bien is here. Lots of celebs, the LDRs, as I like to call them.
Like it.
Is it common, though, for normal folk? Like Kate?
Well, I was going to say, for all us plebs, it's actually...
Kate.
She's not a pleb.
Get off.
Thank you, Susie. Yeah.
It's actually a lot more common than we think, actually, because up to 1 million couples in the UK are having a long-term, a long-distance relationship. And I think I put it down to two reasons. The first is very much due to technology, because now you can get to see somebody, even if they are over the other side of the world, via Skype, via your iVideo phone, 24/7 if you want. You know, it's much easier, and of course it's free. And the other reason is, I think you two wouldn't understand this, of course, being so young and gorgeous and beautiful, but when you do get to a certain age, the dating pool shrinks, so you may have to go a little bit further for love. And of course romantics would say you can't help who or where you fall in love, so maybe that's part of it as well.
Okay. I've tried it before and it didn't work for me, but then again, I'm not that great with technology. I'm better now, but I really wasn't good at the time. But how do you think you can make a long-distance relationship work?
You need to have a lot of effort from both
maybe
parties.
Maybe that's what I was lacking.
Effort.
A bit of effort and energy. You need commitment to the relationship. You need to trust each other as well. Like poor Eva Longoria, a lot of affairs happen not because of any other reason other than opportunity. So you need to have a really strong trust relationship. Mm. And also the other reason to make a long-distance relationship work is if you can create some kind of guide together, in the sense that you can decide, okay, we're going to see each other or speak to each other every day, we're going to see each other every 2 to 3 months. And often what we've seen is when there isn't this kind of guide, long-distance relationships can break up within 2 to 3 months.
Yeah, that sounds like good advice, actually. You've got to both be on the same page and be in agreement with how you're going to make the relationship work.
Exactly, yeah. Really write it down, make it clear.
What is the biggest mistake that people make, though?
I think the physical side of long-distance relationships tends to be very fantastic because nothing gets boring in the bedroom, but on the whole, what can happen is if you've just started seeing someone, it can be very difficult to take the relationship to the next level. A lot of people I've spoken to say that they can almost feel like they're acting in a long-distance relationship.
All right.
Because, you know, everyday life is about the nitty-gritty, boring detail, and in long-distance relationships, often you get to see the warts removed, fabulous, fictionalised version of each other, which isn't what real life's about. And so then when you do come together, you can find, oh my goodness, we haven't really got anything in common after all.
Yeah.
So I think it can be very difficult.
Oh. Yeah. Now, as a relationship expert, we can't not ask you about the Ashley Cole, Cheryl situation. Now, he's doing quite a good job of winning her back. It's all in the papers today that he's buying her a dog.
I know.
Do we think this is going to work? What would your advice be for winning someone back?
Well, I'm a really big dog lover, so I can see why she went fall for
so
it.
So this was a good tactic.
It is a good tactic, but it's awesome. I say, you know, it's quietly manipulative.
Dogs aren't just for Christmas, Simone.
Exactly, exactly. And also, the fact is that these romantic gestures are all very good, but the reason why you broke up tends to be lingering sort of in the background. And once the initial excitement's worn off, where do you go? So if you are sort of trying to woo your ex back, leave the romance and just get talking. Talking about, can you make a difference in this relationship? How have you changed? Or if you're Ashley Cole, are you going to cheat again?
Oh, yeah. If it was me, I think I would make Ashley do an awful lot of grovelling, and that's just for starters.
Yeah, and
I'd have to be really sorry.
Exactly. Build up all the good behaviour. Many dogs.
Yes.
You're not scary. You're really scary,
don't worry,
today.
It's all okay. Simone, great to see you. Thank you very much for your advice.
Thank you.
I think I'd just take a girl to the cinema.
That would work.
It would work.
Not if you're Ashley Cole.